he's like the clown of imperialism. President Obama is like the clown of imperialism. President Obama is a nice person, you know. President Obama has a nice smile. Look at President Obama. When you look at the President Obama, you see a very genuine man. He genuine is not President Obama. All you should be worrying about. All you should be worrying about the people who controlling President Obama. You understand me? The Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve, which is owned by a bunch of international bankers. This is some real capitalistic conspiracy, you know. Go back to all in the safe time, the 1700s, how the Rothschild started, you know. It started with a man doing banking, man, and he discovered one of his kids had a talent for banking. You understand? When he realized his son had a gift for banking, he took this child and started to nurture him in the field of banking. And the family began to escalate on a very minuscule level. But while they began to escalate and grow, one of them discovered that they could capitalize on government. Governments were small at the time. They realized if they could give gold and loan cash to government, they have a much bigger interest. So this family started capitalizing on these bankers back in the 1700s interest. Right? And when banks were going to war, and Britain and certain countries were going to war back in those days, right? Some of the countries will use them as bankers. They will tell the banks, they will tell the bankers, hold our money first, we're going to fight the war. Nobody wants to lose their war, right? I mean, they have bank and ATM machine back in those days, right? They had real physical worth. Money, gold, cash, silver. They had real value, so they needed places to hide it in case they lost a war. And they would hold on to them and they'll give it back to them and they'll pay interest. So this is kind of how they all kind of escalated. This is a very simplistic explanation. Right? And they all had names like the Rothschild. But that's the whole side that's beside the whole idea issue. President Obama answered to the freaking the Federal Reserve. And that's how the Federal Reserve run. It's owned by a bunch of international bankers who the bank owe money. Who do you know? Who the United States owe money? The United States owe 16 point something trillion dollars, man. The United States, well, they just went over to like 17 point something hundred billion, so trillion dollars. They owe trillion dollars to the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve just prints money for the United States. Okay, you want money, America? Hold on. They go in a machine, they print some money. They print $2 billion for the United States and give them as a loan. Where the Federal Reserve get the money from? They just make it. The Federal Reserve just have a machine that make money and give it to the American people, and the American people buy it. You owe them people. Every year the government have a major deficit. Their revenue is supposed to exceed their expenditure, right? But their expenditure is always exceeding their revenue. So when you have a country where your expenditure, right, is always exceeding your revenue, you will never run into a major surplus, right? You'll run into a major deficit. You need your revenue to increase your expenditure, so you can have a major surplus in your company or a major company in the country, right? You have to. What I was going to say? Right? So that's how the government only have a deficit, and they don't have a surplus. So they go to the Federal Reserve and borrow money from the Federal Reserve. And the Federal Reserve loan them money. How much you want? $2 billion? Or hold that. Give me back some interest. Well, I think the government has something right now, just recently called the sequestration. The sequestration is basically a stupid concept. The Democrats and the Democrats, they're always in a bipartition. Yeah, when they come to a bipartition, hear what's stupid about the Republicans and the Democrats, right? Whenever they come to a bipartition agreement, it's a bipartition agreement for something real stupid. Real stupid. A bipartition is basically when two opposing parties disagree, but they come to an agreement for a particular cause or for an overall objective cause of the country and the nation, right? They come to agreement for something called the sequestration. They say, well, the only way we could increase our surplus and lower our deficit, we're going to have to try to cut back on how much we're spending. They cut back on the spending. The government cut back on the spending. They say we're going to cut $800 billion a year. $800 freaking billion dollars a year they're going to cut from the governing expenditure, the annual expenditure. So whatever they spend one year, they decide to cut out eight. We're going to have to cut $800 billion. So the whole, at the end, in like 11 or 12 years, they could save 1.6 something trillion dollars, so it could help increase the government debt. No, we're not the government deficit. I apologize. Deficit. We're not talking about the government debt. The government to have over 17 point something trillion dollars now, because they recently borrowed money from the again. But they haven't started to mess with the debt yet. So far, all they're doing is dealing with the deficit. All they're doing is spending, trying to figure out ways to clear, and the sequestration, it failed miserably. It started a year and a half ago and it failed. It just catapulted into misery. It just cascaded like a freaking river. Right? And the Republicans and every Democrats always in an agreement. For stupidness, you know. But I'm going to talk about some more about this stuff, you know.